And I'm proud to say that within the vicinity of this 5 kilometer radius in this Kampung, we have the most computer scientists, engineers, and not just because the engineers, ada juga yang near the engine lah. Si Bani punya, because some of them didn't have the opportunity to pursue their bachelor's degree in engineering, but they're passionate about engines, so I call them near the engine. So because of that, he bought a book from Amazon.com and he asked me, beli itu buku untuk belajar buat elektrik pakai air. And we had no idea what it was then. He asked me, can use my credit card to buy or not? So I gave him my credit card. And the book was not that expensive, but the shipping was expensive. So because of the book, hello, I'm Stephen Wong. Welcome. You were in the same. So because of that, Bunny has inspired many. And he went to from. Hi Calvin, why me Calvin? Sorry, always call our friends. And because of that, because many engineers were born in this area, that's why I believe in technology, innovation, and the young people being able to take charge. So that's why this place is going to be always part of innovation, and I think Bannie has been leading a lot of things in the community. And hopefully, if we have the opportunity, we will expand it throughout the whole Sabah, because we know that the need for energy, the need to take care of our environment, and all the science, innovation, and all that. I'm very passionate about educating the young, not just through the formal education, which is quite very important, but also outside of schools. So if there's itu saja dari saya. Saya amat berterima kasih kepada semua yang hadir dan memberikan sokongan, terutama sekali kepada YB Yobihin yang berada bersama-sama kita pada petang ini untuk melihat potensi renewable energy, ya, tenaga hijau yang boleh diperkembangkan lagi bukan saja di Sabah tetapi seluruh Malaysia. That is our hope that we will have sokongan lah. Memang mendapat sokongan. We have tried our best. Most of the projects done are funded by NGOs and UN and corporate companies. So Shell, I think the one in the Orang Asli village, yeah? So we would like to hear from our Yang Berhormat Yeo Bihin on this, just to share your experience here. And then of course you've heard a lot of things out there. So kita minta Yang Berhormat untuk memberikan sepatah dua kata. Boleh? Terlibat saudara Tio sini dan juga Renhill daripada saudara-saudari sekalian, selamat petang dan selamat Malaysia Baru. Hari ini saya sangat bangga datang di sini. Kali pertama datang, saya tengok rakan saya, wow, ini center yang create miracles. Miracles happen when someone actually look for innovation and look for technology, because technology changes life. And I think Adrian has embodied that so much. And I am just so amazed that he actually know Amazon so many years ago. So, and because of that,
I'm old.
Things change. And I think this center actually embodied my ministry. Kementerian Tenaga, the other tenaga. Science, technology, the other science and technology. And then climate change. Because it is so related, and environment. And so, so hari ini, I am glad that I agreed, because my schedule, jadual saya sangat packed. Apabila Adrian tanya saya sama ada saya nak datang sini tengok, saya tengok jadual saya pack sangat, tak tahu boleh datang sini ke tak. But I'm so glad that I made the decision to come. Because to us, whether or not this is a small center or a big ministry, I think we serve the same purpose. That is to impact positively the life of the community. And I just want to give a compliment to our saudara here, saudara Adrian. As a new in the new ministry, it is because we have done impian so long, kita telah menjalankan project-project impian dari tahun 2013, dan saya rasa agak tidak adil apabila kita ada kampung-kampung
di Malaysia yang masih tiada elektrik. Kalau dia dapat elektrik pun sekarang lebih mahal daripada apa yang orang yang tinggal di banglo. Dia bayar kurang daripada apa orang di kampung yang bayar untuk electricity. Saya rasa bahawa sebagai satu kerajaan, kita perlu membantu lebih banyak lagi. Saya bagi sikit insider news. Sebab rural electrification bukan directly under energy ministry. It is under rural development ministry. So tetapi apabila kita bincang agensi-agensi, saya telah membuat permohonan supaya rural electrification juga dibawa agensi kementerian tenaga. Sebab kita ada lebih banyak expertise lagi, dan jika kita juga ada satu tabung, nama tabung ini account amanah bekalan elektrik. Di mana ini account ini ada duit dana yang boleh digunakan untuk elektrifikasi di kampung. Tetapi dana ini di kementerian. So kementerian tenaga. Tapi kerja-kerja perlu dibuat oleh rural development. And as all of us know, last time what happened is that millions of ringgit being spent by rural development. Hire big contractor come to kampung don't know how to do. Itu mahal. Engineering jurutera mahal. Tapi masuk kampung
tak tahu.
Dia tak tahu macam mana culture, budaya di kampung, bagaimana kita nak buat maintenance dan lain-lain. So pengalaman saya di Impian beritahu saya satu, mengajar saya satu yang sangat lesson, yang sangat berharga. Saya rasa jurutera yang those big names not necessarily good. They are mesti expensive, but maybe not good. So I think it's time for us to really explore a more economical way and more practical way for people in Sabah. I'm really hoping that rural electrification will come under Kementerian Tenaga. Even if it is not, we will work closely with rural development so that it is also my heart desire, not only in Sabah, Sarawak, dan juga di Semenanjung Malaysia, ada banyak lagi kampung-kampung orang asli yang belum ada electricity. Harap-harap dengan kerajaan baru, Pakatan Harapan, kita boleh mengembalikan keadilan kepada komuniti orang asal dan orang asli. Sekian sahaja. Terima kasih.
Thank you. You've learned from what you saw.
Yeah, Bella, yeah. The purpose is to come and have a look at how does technology and innovation change not only people in the home and the Bandar, how actually people... I've heard about Adrian Center for a long time. Yeah. I heard about this center for a long time, but I haven't had a chance to come. But when he knew that I was coming, he said, why don't you come over and have a look? And I asked, is it near to KK? Is it quite near? So I thought, okay, I'll come over. So I am very glad that I come because you can see how small things like learning from a book, the technology from a book can actually start to turn up into something like center like this. So the purpose is really to come and to learn about technology and learn about how we use engineering, simple engineering to electrify the rural area. That is very important to me as an energy minister. We are not only talking about people with affordable, reliable electricity in the Bandar, but what about people who have no electricity? So that is also a part of our work. So I want to come and see what has been done and then how we can move forward from here.
Okay. Can I ask, we might be a bit tough for you, but we are not ready, it's okay. A bit different question, but of course it's regard with ACSB and the proposed thermal station in Tawau. Have they briefed you on that as a news minister yet?
We have already have a decision on Tawau. We will announce it first soon.
Okay. Is it no-go or no-go? Actually, it doesn't exist.
No, now when the time comes.
On the way to go.
Yes. When are you planning to come back here, I mean, to visit some again, maybe other districts, just to see how they, you know,
I will come when it's needed, okay, time. I have a good portfolio.
Okay.
Yeah, so we will distribute accordingly the time and priority. But what I can say is that Sabah electricity reform is in the agenda, yes, and one of the top priorities for this. As I said just now in my press conference, that it is unfair for Sabahan to have more unreliable electricity than other parts of Malaysia, and it will not help with the economy. So part of it is to have stable electricity. It's something that will help not only Sabah to have a better life, but really on the economy and the investors to come and invest and everything.
So having an assistant minister who is from Sabah just helped reach that market also.
I think Mugira has a lot of passion on Sabahan's welfare, and I think Sabahan's welfare will be much protected in the ministry because you have a deputy minister who is a Sabahan, and she has always opened for Sabahan, always gave perspective as a Sabahan as well in the ministry. I think it helps a lot for us to put into perspective on Sabahan's.
Two more questions, please. Isn't your assistant also a former board of director of ACSB, if I'm not mistaken? No. Okay, one simple question, last. What new things have you discovered from your visit here?
I've discovered a lot of things. It's amazing. You guys have done amazing thing. I do not know a Kampung shop can do it. It's a turbine. I've learned a lot.
Like your beer can be turned into a dynamo?
The beer can into a turbine.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not just beer can, by the way. It also other
aluminium can.
To be politically correct.
Soft drink.
Aluminium cans.
Just say aluminium can.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.